As a concept, running power sounds great. Who wouldn't want to measure the power output of their performance? But what does running power really mean, and what's the point in measuring it? In its simplest form, the number tells you how much power you produce during every segment of your run. More watts equals more power. Many polar watches are equipped with wrist-based running power, so runners can see this metric directly on the watch without needing any additional external devices or pods. Using running power as a training tool, you can easily track your progress. When you produce more power, so higher watts, with less effort, meaning a lower heart rate, than in your previous workouts, you know you're doing something right. It can help you see how efficient you are during your workouts, which can help you tweak your training, your form, and technique accordingly. Monitoring your heart rate and your running power is a match made in running heaven. The power to heart rate ratio is a great progress indicator. Same power plus lower heart rate equals better performance. Other advantages to running power, besides tracking the general trend of your training, is using it to guide your training intensity. Unlike the feeling you have when running, which can often be misleading, watts don't lie. So whether you think you're pushing hard but are actually on cruise mode, or vice versa, the running power number tells you exactly how much power you're producing. Using running power is simple, not much different than looking at any other running metric. You can set up different training views for running workouts, including power metrics, to see your power output in watts at any moment of your run. Your polar watch will display, for example, your maximum power, average power, lap power, and much more. It can also show your current power zone, so you always run at the right intensity. Running power is a very convenient metric when you work on your hill running, which in turn helps build strength and speed. If you want to put your running power to the test, here are a couple of training examples. Number one, uphill sprint training. 15-second interval runs at power over 150% of MAP, your maximal aerobic power, which Polar calculates for you in the physical settings, or a zone 5 heart rate. You can also take the running performance test and get your maximal aerobic power number as a result. Repeat 4 to 8 times depending on how you feel and what your experience level is. Recover for about 90 seconds or until your heart rate is down to zone 2. Number two, uphill high intensity interval training. 30 to 40 second interval runs where power reaches 100 to 120% of MAP, or a zone 4 heart rate during work phase. Repeat 5 to 10 times depending on how you feel and what your experience level is. Recover for about 90 seconds or until heart rate returns to zone 2 or until you feel recovered for the next push. Add a warm up, for example, easy jogging with short sprints, and cool down according to your preferences.